Here in today's lecture, we are discussing first come, first serve scheduling, and the mode we have taken is non-primitive mode. Non-primitive mode is what mode? When a process starts its execution, it will first complete its task, only then it will free the CPU and the other process would be able to execute. So here in this numerical, we have given five processes, P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. The arrival time of these processes are given, and this is the burst time of these processes. It means how much time the process will take to complete its task, how much the CPU cycle it will require to complete its task. Okay, what we need to find here is we need to find out the completion time, turnaround time and the waiting time. Okay, let's talk about the completion time and see how we will execute these processes. In first come first scheduling, we follow the process which arrives at first, that would be served first. So it means the process which arrives first into the ready queue for execution, CPU will give priority to that job and that job would be executed at the first point. And the arrival time of those processes is also important, as the process 1 arrives at 0 time, so it would be executed at the first point. So let's see what is the burst time of the process 1, that is 4. So it means the process 1 will take 4 units of CPU cycles to complete its task, so the completion time would be 4. Let's talk about process 2. It was arrived at time 1 when the process 1 was executing. The process 2 was entered into the ready queue. Now how much time is required by this process? That is 3. So 4 plus 3, the total completion time of process 1 and process 2 would be 7. And let's see, in process 3, it arrives at time 2 when the process 2 was executing. Process 1 was executing, the process 3 was also arrived, and the total completion time would be 8 because its burst time is 1. So 7 plus 1 would be 8. Similarly, process 4, it was arrived at time 3 and it is already into the ready queue, and the burst time of this process is 2. So 2 plus 8 is what? Total completion time is 10. For process 5, it arrives at time 4 and the burst time of this process is what? 5. So total completion time would be 10 plus 5, 15. So how we are completing this, how we are finding this completion? Like first it will take 4 units for P1. For the next one it requires more units. These are 3 units, the total completion time would be 7. Let's talk about the next process. It will take 1 unit, so P3 would take 1 unit and the completion time would be 8. Similarly, next it requires 2 units for P4, it will complete at 10 and so on. More 5 units and it would be completed at time 15. Okay, and